Good morning. In this video, we are going to start with Chapter 5, Arithmetic Progression. An arithmetic progression is a list of numbers in which each term is obtained by adding a fixed number to the preceding term except the first term. So leaving out the first term, from the next one, we can keep adding them and we will get a series of number that is called as arithmetic progression. Each number in the series is called as a term, and the fixed difference that you are having is called as the common difference. And that common difference can be positive, negative, or zero. The general form of arithmetic progression: A denotes the first term, D denotes the common difference. So the list of the terms are, first we'll have A, and then D will be added to it, so A plus D. Then D will be added to it again, so A plus 2D, A plus 3D, etc. This is called as the general form of an AP. AP is short for arithmetic progression. There are two types of arithmetic progression: finite and infinite. Finite, as the name suggests, it means the number of term is going to end. So here we can see 950, 900, 850, so on, it will reach 50. While in infinite, it is not going to have a last term. It's not going to end at all. It will keep going. So we'll have 6, 9, 12, 15. It keeps going. There is no last term for it. Then it is known as an infinite AP. So let us quickly move to exercise 5.1. Second question: write the first four terms of the AP when the first term A and the common difference D are given as follows. A is given to be minus 1 and D is 1 by 2. A1 is the first term for us, which is A itself minus 1. A2, we have to add a common difference, A plus D. So minus 1 plus half, will get minus half. Again, A3, we will add the common difference to the previous term, that is A2. So A2 plus D will be minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2, which is 0. A4, again we'll add it to A3. So 0 plus half will be 0 half. Hence, the first four terms of the AP are minus 1, minus half, 0, and half. Now the fifth part, we are having decimals. A is minus 1.25 and D is minus 0.25. So this AP, we can express any real number are expressed in AP. Okay, so this is an example of a decimal form. A1 is A itself minus 1.25. For A2, we are going to add the common difference. So minus 1.25 plus minus 0.25 will be minus 1.5. A3, we are adding common difference to A2, so it becomes minus 1.75. Now A4, again we add the common difference, minus 0.25 to A3, we will get minus 2. So the first four terms of the AP are minus 1.25, minus 0.5, minus 1.75, and minus 2. Now we are considering fractions. For the following AP, write the first term and the common difference. So till now, we had been expressing the AP, but now APs are given to us. We have to find the first term and the common difference. First term is the first one in the AP, isn't it? 1 by 3, 5 by 3, 9 by 3, 13 by 3. The first one is 1 by 3. So the first term A is 1 by 3. Common difference D we will get when we subtract any two term. Second term from first and first term, third term and second term, fourth term and third term, any successive ones. Okay, if we subtract, we will get the common difference. For convenience sake, we will choose A2 minus A1 usually. Okay, so second term minus first term, which is 5 by 3 minus 1 by 3. So the common difference is 4 by 3. This is the decimal form: 0.6, 1.7, 2.8, 3.9. etc. So first term is 0.6, common difference 1.7 minus 0.6, which will be 1.1. Which of the following are AP? If they form an AP, find the common difference D and write three more terms. Okay, so how do you find if they are AP or not? First, we have to find their common difference. Each and every term's common difference we have to find. And we have to check if it is a common difference or not. That is, whether the number is constant or it is changing. Only if it is a constant, it is an AP. If it is changing, then it is not an AP. Okay, that is the only way to find out if a given series is arithmetic progression or not. So first of all, in the given series, we will assign A1, A2, A3 for each and every values. So A1 is minus 10, A2 is minus 6, A3 is minus 2, and A4 is 2. Now, let us find the common difference for each and every terms. Okay, pair of terms. So first we will find A2 minus A1, we get 4. Then A3 minus A2, we are getting 4 again. A4 minus A3, again we are getting 4. So common difference is the same, isn't it? A2 minus A1, A3 minus A2, A4 minus A3, all are same. Therefore, the given series forms an AP. So we have to subtract the terms, the successive terms, and if the answer is constant, then the series is an AP and the common difference is 4, whatever value that we are getting there. Okay, so now it is an AP. Now the question says find three more terms. So let us find A5, which is A4 plus the common difference 6. Then A6, 6 plus 4, 10. A7, 10 plus 4, 14. Now again, the same fourth question, but we are having root also. Root is an irrational number. Root 2 is an irrational number, but it is a real number. I told you APs will have any real number. So we are having 3, 3 plus root 2, 3 plus 2 root 2, 3 plus 3 root 2, etc. So again, we'll assign the values. A1 is 3, A2 is 3 plus root 2, A3 is 3 plus 2 root 2, A4 is 3 plus 3 root 2. Let us find the difference. A2 minus A1, root 2. A3 minus A2, root 2. A4 minus A3, root 2. They are all equal. So this forms an AP. And our common difference is root 2. So A5 will be A4 plus D. A4 was 3 plus 3 root 2 plus another root 2. So we'll add the irrational terms. So that would be 4 root 2. So 3 plus 4 root 2 is our A5. Now for A6, we have to add the common difference, which is root 2. So it will become 5 root 2. A7, again we'll add root 2 to it. We'll get 6 root 2. So these are our next three terms of this AP. The same question, we are having decimals now. Given that A1, we are assigning the value as 0.2, A2, 0.22, A3, 0.222, and A4, 0.2222. So let us find the common difference. A2 minus A1 is 0.02, A3 minus A2 is 0.002. At this point itself, you know that they are not same, but it's better. We are going to check that again. A4 minus A3, 0.002. Okay. None of them are equal. So this is not an AP. Now you might have a question. What if two of them are equal and just one of them is not equal? Even then, it won't be an AP. It is essential that each and every difference is the same. That is why it is called as common difference. If you are going to have three, four things common difference, but only one alone is not the same number, even then it will not form an AP. Clear for everyone? Now, let us consider fractions for the same type. Minus half, minus half, minus half, minus half. Okay, so let us assign A1, A2, A3, A4 all are minus half. So let us find the difference. A2 minus A1, 0. A3 minus A2, 0. A4 minus A3, 0. So their differences are the same. Therefore, they form an AP. We already saw that common difference can be positive, negative, or 0. So this is an example of 0. So the next term will be, as you already found out, minus half, minus half, and minus half. So we know that when the same number is repeated, it forms an AP. Okay, in this question we have to verify, so we are verifying. But if it had been an MCQ, you directly know that this is going to be an AP just by looking at it. There is no need to check. The next one, we are having exponents, means powers. A square, A cube, A power 4. We have assigned A1, A2, A3, A4 for each of the term. Now let us find the difference. A2 minus A1 is A square minus A. Can you solve this further? No. Maximum we can do is take A common out, but still A minus 1 will remain. That's it. Now here A3 minus A2, A cube minus A square. A4 minus A3, A power 4 minus A cube. None of the differences are equal. Therefore, this is not an AP. Now, again, we are having a root question. Root 3, root 6, root 9, root 12. We'll assign A1, A2, A3, A4 for each term. And let us solve. A3 is root 9, which is 3. A4 is root 12. 12 can be written as 4 into 3. Root of 4 will be 2. And root 3 remains as such. So now the common difference, A2 minus A1, root 6 minus root 3. We cannot subtract it. We are going to leave it as such. A3 minus A2, 3 minus root 6. A4 minus A3, root 2 root 3 minus 3. None of the differences are equal. Therefore, this also does not form an AP. So they are just series. They are not arithmetic progression. That's all. The next one is 1 square, 5 square, 7 square, 73. That's a number, okay? So now A1, we take 1 square, which is 1. A2 is 5 square, which is 25. A3 is 7 square, which is 49. A4 is 73. So let us find the difference. A2 minus A1, 24. A3 minus A2, 24. A4 minus A3, 24. Their differences are the same, therefore they form the AP. Now let us find the next three terms. A5 is A4 plus D, which is 73 plus 24, 97. A6, 97 plus 24, 121. A7, 121 plus 24, 145. With this, we have come to the end of this session. We'll continue the next topic in the next video. Thank you.